What is this quarter?
This is serious. This is serious.
It's serious. It's, apparently, before and after pictures.
Yeah.
It's a. I don't know if you're. It's a pandemic.
Oh. Yes.
It's a fat-phobic pandemic.
Sad. Mm. I've heard it's an endemic now. I'm
well, that's
kidding.
Edema that comes with the before picture.
I got to stop using those.
Yes.
My bathroom has been painted again.
Here you go. This is what went viral this morning.
When diet culture or personal trainers say, take progress photos to stay on track, what they're actually doing is perpetuating the idea, lie, that us humans are healthier when we are smaller, which is simply
trust the
not
science.
True. These transformation photos also demonize the before photo as someone that is not good enough just as they are. And what does this content say about somebody that looks like the before photo? It says you are not good enough as you are, and I have to go to extreme lengths to not look like you, and I'm being celebrated for that. Piggybacking onto fat phobia and body shaming. This content also regularly focuses around women, that a woman's primary focus in life should be to take up as little
horrible
space
choice
as possible,
of words.
Masked as determination or discipline. Lastly, these photos belittle exercise simply down to a weight loss tool, but it is so much more than that.
It's not that much more than that, actually.
Pretty close.
Exercise is about getting healthier
and
transforming your body, which, if you're overweight, usually means becoming less that.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're underweight, becoming less of that too and adding more.
Yeah.
But the before picture wasn't just snapped of you walking into a store.
Right.
It's something that you volunteered for so you could show your weight loss.
That's what you would think.
Well, you would assume.
But people follow me around with cameras all the time. That's the problem with smartphones.
Yeah.
They're not really phones. It's just a way for people to make me feel ashamed of myself.
They're big brother.
They take the worst angles.
This is not what fitness. I love how, by the way, she puts on just enough makeup to say, I'm not. This is me au naturel.
Oh, yeah, I'm so natural.
But look, she looks like a workout instructor. She's not the person to be making this video in a midriff. Like, hey, look at my abs. By the way, it's not good for people.
We
to
need
look
a before and after rhinoplasty.
This is just about getting more market share, right? It used to be that personal trainers, people who were fitness models, or people who were advocating health, they only had access to a market of people who wanted to improve their health.
Yeah.
Now they're saying, well, we can expand that market share to people who don't want to be healthy, and we can just tell them that they're wonderful the way they are.
So you just, what do you do?
It's more crap from big TikTok.
Yeah. Come in and take a nap, and that'll be your workout. What? I don't understand.
She's into fitness, it looks like.
Yeah, she's into fitness, but she doesn't
fitness
want
to. Fitness in her. All right, now.
Okay. Oh, come on.
What?
Dave.
What? Hey, too,
this is why you said it was caffeine earlier.
In her calendar.
See how I stopped myself, though? Didn't actually say it.
That's learning.
You finished it in your head. It's your fault.
Watch Louder with Crowder live, Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern.